It is not clickbait. I am definitely going out on the limb. Not really. I think I'm pretty safe in assuming that Captain America will die. I know there's people theorizing or hoping that Captain America will show up in Falcon and the Winter Soldier and that they're gonna name drop him a ton. And maybe they will. I'm not 100% sure if they will or not, but I do know almost 100% that Captain America will die in Falcon and the Winter Soldier, or at least the version that we have now, which is Old Man Cap. And it can't be a surprise to anyone. And I know some people will probably be saying, oh, there's no way that they'll kill off Captain America in a Disney Plus series. And you're right. The young, vibrant Captain America that we all know, you're right. They wouldn't. They would wait for a featured film to do that in. But Old Man Cap, after he has no more powers, he's just a old man. It has to happen. He has to pass away. And that's why I think you see Bucky and Falcon kind of going back and forth as to, you know, why they need a symbol. And they are like, oh, the people need something to believe in. And they don't take on that mantle before respect out of Old Man Cap or Captain America's memory. And people might be saying, well, in the trailers, they don't show that kind of remorse as to say, you know, Captain America passed away. But look at all the MCU movies. They're so quippy and they make light of deaths of families. And then they don't make light of it, but they don't really emphasize on that dark side of death. It's like, yeah, he passes away. Even when we see, I think it's in Civil War, where Captain America's love interest, Agent Carter, Peggy Carter, passes away. Yeah, we had a few minutes of Cap looking remorse, which I think is we're gonna see that the same, a couple of minutes of Falcon and Bucky kind of feeling the impact of having a dear friend for both of them passing away. And I think that's where what the premise of the show is going to be, or at least the first part of it, is going to focus on, hey, you know, we lost Captain America, and the world will start mourning the passing of Captain America, where you're going to start seeing this passage of the torch. And that's where the Agent America or the Agent is going to come in. And he, for a short time, is going to take the mantle. But I think he's going to be a bad guy. And that's when we're going to have Bucky and Falcon trying to recover the shield, because it means something. It's a symbol of freedom and justice and something to look up to. But now it's in the possession of someone that is not living up to that mantra or to that image. But I don't think it's far off. I might be wrong, but I think if I was telling the story and make it a lot more impactful, or how would I make it a lot more impactful? And I get it. It's Disney Plus. It's a miniseries. You're not expecting some kind of big bombshell like that. But I think it's the writing's in the wall. I think if we're following this right after Endgame, where I could only assume that Peggy Carter still died around the same time she died, and we have the last leg of Captain America or Old Man Cap. I think, you know, it's just good storytelling to have Cap and here the Cap that we know, the one that went back in time and depending on who you believe or what you hear, messed up the timelines. And we're just gonna have him pass away in the morning, and we're gonna have the story play out. Where it leads to, that's anybody's guess. And I'm sure as when that first episode drops, the theories will be nonstop, the same as we had with WandaVision. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. Do you think I'm onto something? Do you guys also think that Captain America will die in this miniseries? Or do you think I'm just looking too much into it? Now, I thought I saw that one of the episodes was called, you know, Rest in Peace, Old Man Cap, or something to that effect. So I might be already late and this thing has already been, you know, put out there. I just think it's this common sense as to that's going to be the catalyst that leads off the events that we're going to see in Falcon and the Winter Soldier. But, you know, let me know in the comments what you guys think. Put your theories in the comments and let's talk about it. Let's see what ideas you guys have in your heads and what expectations you guys are putting on this miniseries. I know coming behind WandaVision, you know, it has a lot to live up to or to match the excitement that we had in WandaVision. So again, put your thoughts down in the comments. And like always, that's a wrap.